Hi, I'm Kylie. Welcome to the Pinnacle Music Museum.
Welcome to Pinnacle's Virtual Music Museum. I'm Bruce, and I want to share a few thoughts with you all. I like music because music is the language of the soul. Musical instruments are made all over the world. I sure hope you enjoy your visit today.
The first exhibit is the Renaissance Room, so come on, Miss Sydney is waiting.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. Hi, I'm Sydney, and I'm in sixth grade, and I've been at Pinnacle since preschool. This is the Renaissance Room. The Renaissance period in music history happened from the 1400s to the 1600s. A lot of changes were happening in the Western world during this time, and the music was changing too. In churches during the Renaissance period, there were lots of masses and motets sung in Latin. It was very common for larger ensembles to play together during this time. One famous Renaissance composer was Guillaume Dufay. He wrote masses, hymns, motets, short sacred songs, and ballads. All of his music was choral or vocal, which means he wrote music for singers.
Hi, my name is Mike, and today I'm playing a recorder. A recorder is just a hollow tube with a mouthpiece on it that directs the flow of air that I blow through it. These kinds of instruments have been around as long as human beings have been around. In very, very ancient times, human beings made flutes out of animal bones, and they would hollow them out and carve little holes in them. This recorder also has holes in it, and I cover up those holes with my fingers. And when I blow through it, depending on which holes I cover up or uncover, it changes the sound or the pitch, and I can make a melody. I'm going to play a melody for you, and this melody is based on the 23rd Psalm. And it's called, My Shepherd Will Supply My Need.
It must be time to go to the next exhibit. Thanks for visiting the Renaissance Room.
Hi, I'm Kylie. Welcome to the Pinnacle Music Museum. This is the Baroque Room. The Baroque started in the 1600s. In Rome, Italy. From there, it spread all over Europe. Baroque describes something that is highly decorated, and buildings were decorated with gold, and the music was decorated with lots of extra notes together called trills. Also associated with the Catholic Church. This is a picture of G.F. Handel. Handel is famous for composing The Messiah in 1741. Perhaps you've heard a choir sing this song around Christmas time.
It's time for the next exhibit.
Welcome to the classical period and the classical museum. You just left the Baroque period, entering into the classical period, and then when you finish here, you'll be on your way to the Romantic period. The classical period falls between the Baroque and the Romantic, and the dates were 1750 to 1820. On a purely musical level, there was simply more to hum along to in the classical period. Better melodies, better tunes, if you will. That's different than the Baroque period, where there were a lot of complex polyphony, or a lot of instruments playing at the same time. A famous composer of the classical period is Joseph Haydn. Haydn was born in Austria into a modest family and worked for one family, the Esterházy family, for 30 years. Can you imagine working in one place for 30 years? After he left the Esterházy family, he accepted an invitation to visit England. He found tremendous public success there. Despite his humble beginnings and early difficulties, Haydn died a renowned and wealthy composer. He is well known for being the father of the string quartet and also played a crucial role in developing the piano trio. Popular instruments of the classical period include the violin and the expansion of the orchestra.
Hi friends, I want to show you one of my favorite instruments. This is one of the first instruments I ever learned to play. This is a violin. And a violin is in the string family because it has strings. A violin came from something called a lute. So a really long time ago in the Renaissance era, that's when you saw Miss Sydney, she was leading you through that room. A lute was played during that time. Now we're in the classical period and they have violins. So people like Mozart wrote songs for violins. And this is called the bow. This is what we play the strings with. In the classical era, they used to use horsehair to make bows. Now they don't do that anymore because it's kind of a PETA thing. We don't like that, that's not kind to animals. So this is made out of synthetic hair, which means fake hair. But it used to be made out of horsehair, and this used to be made out of bone when it first happened. Again, we don't really like that anymore, so it's not. So that's a violin.
Hope you've enjoyed your time here at the Classical Museum. You'll enjoy the Romantic period.
Friends, this is the Romantic Room, and I am your exhibit tour guide, Ms. Laurie. I'm so excited to tell you a little bit about this time in musical history. Let's dive in. The Romantic era is what we call the period of music that lasted from 1820 to 1910. During this musical era, composers made music that many describe as individualistic, emotional, and dramatic. A lot of the music during this time was inspired by nature, books, and poetry. The melodies were passionate, and there was a big emphasis not just on nature, but on the supernatural.
One of the reasons I love the Romantic period in musical history is because of one very famous composer. Maybe you've heard of him, Ludwig von Beethoven. Although he lived from 1770 to 1827, Beethoven's music is still listened to all over the world today. In fact, he's probably one of the most admired composers in the history of Western music. You all just came from the classical room, right? Well, Beethoven actually started writing his music during that time, but his career transitioned into this period of music, the Romantic period. One interesting fact about Beethoven is that he began to go deaf in the middle of his musical career. Still, he was able to make incredible music.
Does anyone know any of the main instruments used during the Romantic period in musical history? Most music during this time was written for the piano and for stringed instruments. Maybe some of you played the piano or a stringed instrument like violin, viola, or cello. Listen to this clip of music to get an idea of what music sounded like during this time. Wasn't that beautiful? I love listening to music like that. Uh-oh, sounds like it's time for you to move on to the room in your museum tour. Next up is the modern room. You're going to love your tour guides there, Raina and Caroline. Have fun. Thanks for visiting the romantic room.
My name is Caroline, and this is my friend, Ollie the Owl.
And I'm Raina, and this is Sid the Squirrel.
And welcome to the modern room. The modern era began in 1910 and is still going on.
A lot of music written during the modern era is based on rhythm and focused on more untraditional sounds.
Here are some examples of unusual instruments used to create rhythm in modern music.
For example, this is the slapstick, but I like to call it the clapper.
And this is my favorite, and it's called a ratchet. It's really loud.
We got the classic cowbell.
And then these are called wood blocks, and I like them a lot. The word rhythm refers to the arrangement of the musical sounds, meaning the beat of the song. Now, I'm going to play a rhythm and Raina's going to repeat it, and I want you guys to clap along with Raina at home. Are you ready? Good job!
A lot of modern music is made with technology, such as the electric guitar.
Hey guys, you just heard from Miss Raina and Miss Caroline that a lot of modern music uses technology, and this is one example of this. This is an electric guitar, so hence the name, it uses electricity, and this is what it sounds like when you do plucking.
Unusual instruments, and they are called boomwhackers. The way it works is you hit it on the ground and it makes a sound that is a note on the musical scale. For example, this one is a B.
This one is a D.
And this one is an A.
This one is a G.
Thank you for coming to the modern room.
We hope you enjoyed your visit to Pinnacle's Virtual Music Museum.
Bye, everybody!